see what we have here. Well, for some positive integers p, quadrilateral ABCD has positive integer side lengths, perimeter p, right angles at B and C. I'm going to draw the quadrilateral. I'm not going to worry about p right now, but draw a quadrilateral with right angles at B and C. Put those down at the bottom. A, B, C, D. And AB is 2. And CD and AD have the same length. All right, we want to find how many different values of P, the perimeter, less than 2015 are possible. And all these side lengths are integers. We're going to need an equation somewhere. I'm going to throw some variables on this. I'm going to call BC. We're going to call that J. We're going to call AD and CD K. And, well, we need an equation. We're going to build a right triangle. So I'm going to go ahead and draw that right triangle in right now. There's the obvious right triangle to add. This length, we've got a rectangle down here because we're told that these are right angles. This length here is J, this over here is 2, this is K, and this has to be K minus 2 because CD and AD have the same length. And there's a right triangle that's going to give us that equation we need. Use the Pythagorean theorem, we have J squared plus K minus 2 squared equals K squared. Go ahead and expand this, we'll have J squared plus K squared minus 4K plus 4, it's all K squared, and conveniently those K squareds cancel out. We can solve for J squared if we want to. J squared equals 4K minus 4, you can also think of that as 4 times K minus 1. You know, we could also solve for K if we wanted to. We could divide this both sides by 4 and add 1, we can say that K equals J squared over 4 plus 1. And in this view, it's really clear J has to be even in order for K and J to both be integers. And any time J is even, K and J are both integers, and we have a nice integer perimeter. Now the question is when is that perimeter less than 2015? So let's write an expression for that perimeter. We got 2 plus J plus 2k. Now we have this expression for k, so we can get rid of that. It'll be 2 plus j plus double this. Well, 2 times the 1 gives us another 2, so it'll be 4 plus j squared over 2, because we have to double that. And we need this expression to be less than 2015. Now again, j can be any positive even integer, and both j and k will pop out as integers. So our problem now is just simply counting the number of positive even integers that make this inequality true. Clearly, starting from the lowest, 2, that's going to work. 4 is going to work. 6 is going to work. We just keep going up. I'm going to use my answer choices here to guide my guesses. I'm going to start with the easy one down here, 30. Well, the 30th positive even integer is 60. Is that going to work here? 60 squared is 3,600, divided by 2 is 1,800, plus 60 plus 4. That works like a charm. I'm going to go up one, though, because I'm not going to go all the way up here to these yet, because when we put 60 in here, we got something real close to 2015. We put in the 31st positive even integer, that's 62. 62 squared divided by 2, that's 31 times 62. That's doubling 31 squared, so 31 squared, that's 961. Double that, I get 1,922. 1922, add 62, add 4, I'm still less than 2015, so that works. I just want to check, make sure what happens when I go to the 32nd positive even integer. That's 64. 64 is 2 to the 6th. 2 to the 6th squared is 2 to the 12th, divided by 2 is 2 to the 11th. That's 2048. That's too much. So all the positive integer even integers from 2 to 62 work here, and no more work. So that's 31. Positive even integers that work. And we're done.